Good morning, friends. Today I am going to talk about enzyme kinetics, which is one of the important part in physical chemistry for CSIR NET examination. So enzyme kinetics. So first of all, what is enzyme? Enzymes are nothing but they are proteins with relatively high molar mass in the order of 10,000 or more. So what enzyme does? The enzyme catalyzes, or it has the capability to catalyze a specific reaction. And enzyme catalysis is an example. So example of homogeneous catalysis. So same phase catalysis. So in this topic, we are going to learn the physical aspects of enzyme. So Michaelis Menten proposed this enzyme kinetics method. So we will start with the derivation first. So this is our free enzyme and this is our substrate. So enzyme and substrate binds to give an enzyme substrate activated complex. This is our enzyme substrate activated complex, and this enzyme substrate activated complex and the free enzyme and substrate are in equilibrium. So this is the K1 is the rate of the forward reaction, whereas K inverse 1 is the rate of the reverse reaction. Then what happens after the enzyme substrate activated complex is formed? Then this activated complex undergoes decomposition to give the product and the enzyme. So we are starting with the enzyme and our reaction ends with the enzyme. So enzyme basically takes part in the reaction, but there is no loss in concentration of enzyme. So first thing here, before we start the derivation, we have to take some assumptions. So what are the assumptions? The first is that the concentration of enzyme with respect to the concentration of substrate is very, very negligible. So concentration of enzyme with respect to substrate is very, very negligible. This is an assumption. And another assumption is that the total enzyme concentration remains constant. Okay, so E0 is nothing but E plus Ex. So the total concentration of enzyme is nothing but the free enzyme concentration and the enzyme concentration when it gets bind to the substrate. So now we can see from this that enzyme substrate complex is formed and simultaneously it undergoes decomposition. So if we apply steady state approximation, so what will happen? So the rate of formation of enzyme substrate complex is equal to zero. So we are applying steady state approximation. So this becomes zero. That means rate of formation of ES, that is K1 ES. So the rate of formation of ES is equal to the rate of decomposition of ES. So it's getting decomposed by two pathways, either this pathway or this pathway. So what happens here? This one is K inverse ES plus K2 ES. Now, from here, we got E0 equal to E plus ES. So this we can write as E equal to E0 minus ES. So just putting the value of E equal to E0 minus ES here. Here we are putting, here instead of this E, we are putting this value. So what we will get? K1 is basically E0 minus ES multiplied by S is equal to K inverse 1 ES plus K2 ES. Next, so this one is K1 E0 S. So K1 E0S minus K1 ESS equal to K inverse ES plus K2 ES. Fine. Now what happens? This term has no ES part. So this term has ES part, this term has some ES part, and this term has one ES part. So we will take all this ES part together. So what will happen? So if we take ES part together, so it will happen like this. K1 S plus K inverse plus K2 ES equal to K1 E0 S. Clear? Fine? Okay. Then, okay, I am erasing this one. I am doing it over here. So we are doing here. So ES, the concentration of ES comes to be K1 E0 S by K2 plus K inverse plus K1 S. Okay. So if you are if you divide both sides, the denominator as well as the numerator, by K1, then what we will get? We will get E0S by K2 plus K inverse by K1 plus S. By getting this one, ES is equal to E0S by K2 plus K inverse by K1 plus S. This one is nothing but KL. This is Michaelis Menten constant. So what will be the unit of this, we'll later on discuss. So this becomes E0S by KM plus S. Now, the earlier step we have seen that in the last step during the product formation, so rate of product formation, that is the rate of reaction, is K2 into ES. This is K2 into ES. Just we are putting it over here. So this comes to be rate equal to K2 E0 S by Km plus S. So this is the equation you need to remember. Okay. So you can pause the video and take it down. Okay, so next we'll just remember this formula. Is the formula rate is k2 is 0 s by kn plus s. Okay, so km is k2 plus k inverse by k1. This, now what is k2? K2 is rate of decomposition of ES to product side. So it is the first order. So its unit will be second inverse. What is k inverse? It is also a decomposition of the NGM substrate complex towards the reverse side, means towards NGM plus substrate. So this is also first order. So first order plus first order, this comes to be first order, second inverse, and K1 is nothing but the second order kinetics, because this is the rate of formation of NGM substrate which depends on the concentration of NGM as well as the substrate. So it is the second order. The second order, mole inverse, liter, second inverse. So if you cancel out this thing, you will get second inverse will cancel out. And this is mole per liter. So the unit of Km is mole per liter. So from this equation also, you can see, from this equation you can see, so this is the substrate concentration S. So it has a unit of mole per liter. Since it is added to Km, so these two must have same unit. So that is why Km has unit same as that of the substrate concentration. So it's the concentration, basically concentration unit. So if we plot the reaction rate, if we are going to plot it, say rate of reaction versus substrate concentration. So see here, if we have a low substrate concentration, let's say here, when the substrate concentration is very, very low, so what will happen? At very low substrate concentration, we'll get Km plus S0S, we can write as Km. Okay. So what happens? So rate becomes k2 e0 s by km. So this come. So the rate is first order. So the rate is first order with respect to substrate concentration. So this will be some linear like this. Okay, so let's go to higher S value. So when at higher S value, at very high S value, what happens? Km plus S will become S. This one will become S now. So this equation will be k2 e0 s, k2 e0 s by s, because this km plus s0 or s, sorry, km plus s is nothing but s at very high concentration of s. So it will be s. So s will cancel out. So the rate is directly proportional to 0th power to substrate concentration. That means rate does not depend on substrate concentration when the substrate concentration is very high. So let's say here, so rate does not vary with substrate concentration very high value. So this is zero order, this is first order, and this is the stage where we will get. So this is like this, we will get the plot like this. So this is our here. So this is the maximum value of rate. So the maximum value of rate we can write at as R max. Right here, R max. So this is the maximum value of rate. So what is R max? R max is, so this one is actually R max. Now becomes R max. So R max is nothing but K2 is 0. Because when the substrate concentration is very high, then rate becomes equal to K2 into E0, and that rate is nothing but the maximum rate, R max. So R max is K2 into E0. Now when Km is equal to S0, when Km is equal to S, when Km is equal to S, then what happens? So R equal to K2 E0 S by Km is S0. So we can write Km as S plus S, that means 2S. So S cancel out, so it becomes K2 E0 by 2. What is K2 E0? K2 E0 is R max. So R max by 2. So here what is the R max? Which one is R max? This is R max. So half of R max is this one. Let's say this one is R max by 2. So the corresponding substrate concentration, this is our Km. So when the substrate concentration is equal to Km here, then the rate is nothing but the half of maximum rate. Fine? Okay. So next we will talk about two types of plot. Okay, before that I want to say one thing, that is this K2 is called the turnover number. So if you are given to calculate the turnover number, the K2 is basically the turnover number, and K2 by Km, this is catalytic efficiency. So K2 is the turnover number, and K2 by Km is nothing but the catalytic efficiency. The efficiency of the catalyst is determined by this value. So now we will move on to the two types of plot. One is the line over bar plot, and another one is Eddy Hofstra plot. So first one is line over bar plot. So line over bar plot is basically the plot between 1 by R versus 1 by S. Okay. So 1 by R versus 1 by S. So here you can see that just do the reciprocal of this. Take the reciprocal of this, this one. So this is R equal to K2E0S by Ka plus S. So 1 by R is basically, this one is Km plus S by K2E0S. Okay, so this will come as 1 by R equal to, this one is Vmax or Rmax, so Km by Rmax into 1 by S plus 1 by Rmax. So this is 1 by Rmax. So we will plot between 1 by R and 1 by S. Okay, so 1 by R versus 1 by S plot. So the plot will be like this. Plot will be like this. 1 by R and here 1 by S. So you can see it's Y equal to MX plus C plot. So it will be a straight line like this, where you will get the intercept as, so this is our slope, this is our slope, so slope is Km by Rmax and our intercept, this is our intercept, that is 1 by Rmax. Fine. So this is all about the line about plot. Okay, so this is the line about work plot. So this is our line about work plot. So next we will talk about AD Hofstede plot. So if you want to take a snapshot, you can take from here. So next is AD Hofstede. I'm doing it here. So AD Hofstede plot. So here what happens? This is a plot by R by S versus R. AD Hofstede, R by S versus R. Okay. So just cross multiply. So R Km plus R S is equal to, this one we will take as Rmax. Rmax S. Fine. So RKM equal to Rmax S minus RS. So dividing it by R by SKM equal to Rmax minus R. Okay. So next comes R by S is equal to Rmax by Km minus R by Km. Okay. So our plot will be R by S versus R. So if we plot this, here we have R by S and here we have R. So you can see, so Y equal to minus MX plus C. So minus MX plus C. So it's a straight line with negative slope. Okay. So it's a straight line with negative slope. So what is the slope? So slope is minus 1 by Km. So if you are asked the magnitude, just take 1 by Km. So minus sign indicates that it's a negative slope, means with increase in R, R by S decreases. And this intercept, So intercept is R max by Km. So these are the two important methods in order to calculate all the parameters in enzyme kinetics. So in the next video we will discuss about some numerical based on the enzyme kinetics, like we will talk about the line over bar plot, how to do some numericals based on this line over bar plot or based on this type of formula. There are some numericals which are already given in CSI and NET to find the K2 value, to find the catalytic efficiency, like this. So in the next video we will discuss few numericals based on this topic. So that's all for this video. So if you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe for being updated. Thank you.